Hello everyone, welcome to Code & Learn. So in the last lesson, we created Postgres test container using test containers and the Postgres test container module provided by test containers. In this video, we are going to set up our test scripts or the SQL scripts required to create the table in the database and perform tests. So let us do that. In here, I'm going to create a directory test data. By Go convention, test data should hold the test data used for testing and is not compiled into the final binary. Inside it, I will create another directory called SQL. Inside SQL, I will just create store.sql that will hold our store scripts. First thing, I'm going to create an extension that will be used to create the UUIDs. So create extension if not exist, UUID OSSP. Next, create a table. The table is called news. Create table if not already exists, news ID, which is a primary key. As we declared in our model, default is UUID generate v4. Then author, title, summary, content, source, tags, created at, deleted at, and updated at. Now let's populate this table with some test data. So here I'm creating two valid news data and one which is deleted. Because we are setting a deleted at field to now, that means it is soft deleted. Let's format it so that it's visible. So just to revise, what we did here was, first we created an extension to create our UUIDs. Then we created the table news in our database. Then we inserted three records. The first two are valid records, that is they are not deleted, and then a soft deleted record. With our SQL script now ready, let us create the test database. Here first I'm going to create a variable called db, which is of type bun.db. Then we are going to use test main to initialize our database using test container. So we can do func test main m testing dot m. Let us create a context. Context dot background Postgres DB cleanup function error create test DB provide the context. If error is not nil, we just panic with the error to say that there was an issue setting up test containers. Now let us set up the variable DB to Postgres DB. Then we need to run the test with code by running m.run, save the code, perform the cleanup, error not is equal to nil, we panic with an error. If everything works out, we will say worst.exit with the code that we got from running the test. So that's our test main setup. First we create a variable db which is a pointer to bun.db, then inside test main we use create test db to create the Postgres db from test containers. Then we run the test. And in the end, we perform cleanup. And finally, we exit with the code that we get from running the test. Now let's ensure everything is working as expected. For that, I'm going to create a test function test store, the create method on the store, t testing dot t. Inside it, I will just initialize a new store from the DB. So we can say news dot new store, provide the DB that we created in test main. Now let's try the test and see everything is working. This is failing because for the test to run, the Docker daemon should be running. So let's start Docker. So now, once our Docker is started, we can try again. I'm going to minimize it, run the test again. And as you can see, everything is working as we expected. In the next lesson, we are going to actually write some create news tests to verify that creation of news is working as expected. If you have any questions, please feel free to post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!